Well, it's Friday, June 16th. I'm meteorologist Quaylen Murphy with your tropics update for the Atlantic Basin, the Gulf Caribbean Sea, and the Atlantic Ocean. Out there, we have a busy setup right now. Starting to see some activity. The tropics slowly coming alive. One area closer to home of concern, the other way out in the open waters of the Atlantic. We'll focus on what's closer to home first, and that's an area of disturbed weather closer to the Caribbean Sea. Right now, just seeing lots of thunderstorms developing down here, closer to the Yucatan, close to San Salvador, but nothing yet organized. A 60% chance we'll see something organizing by the weekend. So, of course, the National Hurricane Center is watching that closely. Some gradual development is possible, and we expect a slow movement of this system into the southwestern Gulf, whatever it is, whether tropical or not. The other system way out here around the Cabo Verde Islands, a strong tropical wave, slow development, if any, also through the next several days. And we'll expect to watch this area of disturbed weather moving west at between 15 and 20 miles per hour, but from 20% up to 40% within the next 5 days. Now, what we're watching closely down here around the Yucatan is the wind shear. So you can see a whole lot of wind shear through the Gulf of Mexico over the Yucatan Peninsula. So wind shear is what helps storms to not organize, because you get those upper level winds and they allow for a very disturbed atmosphere down here around the Yucatan. Though into Saturday, we expect that wind shear to begin relaxing, hence that being an area of potential concern from the National Hurricane Center. Rolling through the rest of the weekend into Monday of next week, we'll begin to see wind shear relaxing closer to the Yucatan Peninsula and into the Gulf of Mexico. So again, that's why the National Hurricane Center has this entire area outlined in that 60% chance potential for development. This will continue through the middle of next week as well, the wind shear relaxing through the southern Gulf and even stretching towards the central Gulf of Mexico. So this is why we'll be watching this area very closely into next week. Bottom line here is that it's too early to try to speculate anything developing, but of course we want to take a look at the forecast models to show you what they're sort of spitting out right now with the latest model data. So what I have here are two forecast models, one being the European, which is outlined in the yellow. The GFS model is the one outlined in the green. So both agree by Sunday that we could have a broad area of low pressure somewhere over the Yucatan Peninsula through Sunday afternoon. And then as we start to move into next week, both are still agreeable that we could have some disturbed weather very close by. The Euro sort of maintaining more of the closed possible circulation down here around the Yucatan, while the GFS grows sort of in the Gulf. And this is where we still see a broad area of low pressure, very much still organized. And then even as we go further out into the middle of next week, the Euro wants to try to keep something more organized closer to the southern Gulf, while the Euro just sort of branches out with a broad area of low pressure. Bottom line, again, I want to emphasize that it's too early to speculate anything. There's one model, the Canadian, that tries to toss something way up here towards the Florida coast, and that's not something that we're totally on board with at this point. So again, something to watch through the weekend and early next week. Are we overly concerned at this point? Not at all. Here's your forecast for hurricane frequency. Of course, we know the peak. We're nowhere near that. That comes September 10th, climatologically speaking, and then we see a big drop off into October and November. That's the latest on the tropics for the Atlantic Basin. Thanks for joining us here online at WDSU.com.